Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Erwan Métayer and I'm a PhD student in the Acoustics Laboratory at Le Mans University. My supervisors are Professor Pascal Picard and Professor Charles Pezra. My talk today is about vibration force identification from high-speed digital holographic measurements. The outline of my talk is as follows. First, I will discuss the context of this work, and then I will briefly present the principle of force identification and more precisely the FAT method, its goal and its limits. Then, I will briefly remind the principle of digital holography. Measurements are carried out in order to verify and validate the principle of force identification in harmonic domain. Then, the method will be adapted in temporal domain and results will be shown. Finally, I will conclude my talk by giving two conclusions and outlooks. Our work are intended to enable new studies in vibroacoustics and to address new issues. As a general rule, vibroacoustic measurements are performed on structures excited by known and repeatable methods, allowing high-performance analysis. However, a large number of structural excitations are related to unsteady excitation, such as noise generated by free structure interactions and certain types of shocks. These excitations can be repeated and thus prevent the use of tools requiring a repeatable source, such as a scanning vibrometer. The goal of this work is an effort to adapt a real-time full field measurement techniques that allow the simultaneous capture of a large number of measurement points to the case studies, which is the identification of force in cases where the repeatability of the excitation is not possible. In a direct problem, the displacement field of the structure is generally a solution and can be computed with prior information on the structure, excitation conditions and boundary conditions. In the case of an inverse problem, the displacement is known from measurements and one aims at knowing the force applied to the plate. The inverse resolution, noted here FAT, is a method that can be used without any boundary conditions. Thus, only the dose that remain in the problem. The principle of the inverse problem is an effort to retrieve the excitation that caused the displacement. It is based on the general equation of motion of the plates. Structural parameters, such as structural stiffness d, damping factor epsilon, density rho, or geometry, for example h for the thickness, are known as well as the measured displacement w. The force can thus be recovered by solving the equation of motion. The special derivatives in the space domain are approximated by the finite different scheme. Temporal derivations are adapted according to each cases. In the harmonic regime, it is grossly simplified. As example of such resolutions, please consider the case of noise-free measurement. The position of the force can be easily retrieved because it is highly localized. In the case of real measurements, where noise is included in data, the special derivation will amplify the measurement noise, making it difficult to localize the force. These special derivations will be even trickier at the edge of the field of view because of the use of non-stereo scheme of derivations. This method must therefore be regularized. The first approach for the regularization is to consider where the artifacts due to noise are located. These ones are located in the high wave numbers. So, a first approach for regularization is to filter the signal using a neutral low-pass filter to attenuate the impact of the noise on the resolutions while not distorting the signal. Edge derivatives can be attenuated by a Tuckey window applied on the useful signal. This method yields a correct but coarser estimate of the force. Note that the size of the filter also needs to be adapted according to the noise included in measurement. Recently, our group proposed regularization based on statistical approach. This approach uses a matrix formulation of special derivatives to simplify the expression of the movement. By using a Bayesian approach and knowing the power spectral density of the noise from the measurement, the Bayesian force estimator can be expressed as this equation. This formulation is in fact a regularization of the special derivatives by modifying the singular values of the derivation matrix after decomposition. This modification is made by a factor eta power 2 to be determined. This factor can be determined by minimizing a cost function. The position of the force is then found, like in this example. With this approach, the regularization process is made automated and do not require any, I would say, manual adjustments. The principle of digital holography results in the interaction of two optical phenomena. First, the diffusion of a light illuminating the structure. A part of the light is re-emitted by the object and will illuminate the camera's sensor array and interfere with the reference wave. The recorded hologram will be as described by the equations, with R, the reference wave, and O, the object waves. By pre-recording the hologram and focusing on a diffraction order to be processed, we'll be able to isolate the object field. A retropropagation of the recorded hologram is then performed to get the complex object field. The movement at the object surface is reconstructed by subtracting the optical phases between consecutive instants. The algorithm discussed in the previous talk permits to retrieve operational deformations of the structure under harmonic excitation. Now let's consider the practical implementation. To check if the proposed approach is adapted, the vibration of a plate are measured for a set of 4 frequencies up to 6 kHz. The plate under test is from steel. The edges are damped to prevent the plate from resonances. The holograms are recorded at a frame rate of 12.5 kHz at high spatial resolutions, and the illuminated surface is 15 by 15 square centimeters. FAT method is applied on measurement in order to retrieve the position and the values of the force for the two regularization methods on 4 frequency tested. The results are finally compared with the resolutions performed with point pulse vibrometers measurement. Operational deformations obtained with digital holographic measurements are visible on top, while the result of the force distribution both for filters and windows and Bayesian regularizations are below. These results permit to locate the force at the expected localizations. One remarkable thing is that the method allows to highlight the presence of a force emitted by an excitation moment. After integrating the force profile on the entire surface, the force values are compared with results resolved from point pulse vibrometers measurement. The forces resolved with point pulse vibrometer measurements are shown for filters and Bayesian regularizations, respectively in blue and orange color, while the results obtained with holographic measurements with the same regularization in yellow and purple. Results obtained in each case are similar, demonstrating that the results obtained with digital holographic measurements with the deformation reconstruction algorithm are coherent with those obtained from reliable method measurements. To obtain temporal force resolutions, the FAT method needs temporal input data. Digital holography permits to obtain synchronous measurements in one acquisition sequence. Since the time sequence of the recorded hologram does not include any stationary vibrations, the previous vibration retrieval algorithm we called VibMap cannot be used. The successive differences of phase image at each instance time Tn is directly used to yield the velocities of the structures and described by this equation. The inverse problem for force identification need to be adapted to data from holography, knowing the expression of movement from velocity in the time domain. To test the method, the transient excitation is performed by an impact hammer on the previously tested structure at the same resolutions, but at a recorded frame rate of 14 kHz. The inverse resolution is performed as follows. First, a Fourier transform is applied on temporal domain on the series of temporal maps obtained from digital holography. The resolution is then applied for each frequency and regularized by Bayesian approach as it regulates itself automatically. Finally, an inverse Fourier transform is applied to obtain the force profile in the time domain. These slides present the experimental results. On the left, you can see the velocity map of the structure as a function of time. The impact arise at time is equal to 0 seconds. With the impact hammer, the excitation force distribution is a function of time. The estimated force obtained by the inverse resolution is visible on the red square. Please watch the left part of the video. You can see a shock impacting the plate. Now, please look at the right part. You can clearly see the trace of the impact of the force at the place where the shock is emitted. It is therefore possible to temporarily follow up the force injected into the plate by this method. When comparing the holographic and vibrometric measurements, a great similarity between the two velocity profiles can be observed. This confirms that the time profile of the holographic measurements is correct. So, the full field measurement provided by high-speed digital holography yields accurate results. By specially integrating around the point of emission of the force, we can obtain the force profile emitted in the plate. Here it is compared to the force profile measured from the impact hammer. The temporal profile of the excitation is well retrieved as well as the amplitude. The same type of resolutions can be performed with more complex excitations, like two hammers impacting the plate. In this slide, we can see the same method applied on a signal generated by two hammers impacting the structure with both spatial and temporal proximity. Results show again a good agreement between force tensor and retrieve force with FAT method. Note that this resolution is performed with one integration over all the impact area. Multiple signals can be retrieved with one post-processing operation. To separate each component of the signal, multiple post-processing operations are needed. To conclude this talk, we have validated the use of ultra-fast digital holography by obtaining very satisfactory comparisons. With scanning vibrometry, comparisons were performed for both the harmonic and transient excitations. The force applied to the structure is also recovered for each case. Firstly, in the harmonic regime, where the measurement force is very similar to that obtained with the data from the vibrometer, and secondly, in the transient regime, where profiles are close to that provided by the force sensor. The inverse resolution methods also make it possible to highlight force originating from an excitation moment. This work will allow deepening the studies of the inverse resolutions in the transient regime by applications on different types of non-repeatable sources, such as object bearing or more complex excitations, such as aeroacoustics. The temporal resolutions will then have to be improved by more in-depth studies on the numerical processings applied to the measurements, as well as taking into account the speckle noise profile in the Bayesian regularization measurements. This concludes my talk. Thank you for your attention.